So I managed to get it out on Thursday. If you, anybody who follow me on Facebook, see I was running around Thursday evening toward my Thursday tour of the north end of the county, the tour of the third. So I went up to Chapco Park to visit with Southern Maryland BMX, and it was their one of their first practices of the season, and they're gearing up for an actually a state qualifier for BMX that they're going to hold at Chapco Park, and that's in May 6th. On May 6th, I'll have more information on that as it gets to me. They've done a great job up there with the BMX park. I remember when it was first built, when I was still coaching soccer at Chapco Park, and it was from where they started and where they are now is a testimony, a good relationship between Southern Maryland BMX and Rec and Parks, and this board that has helped with that, with the facilities at that, at that portion of the park. And I jealously walked over to the turf fields and talked to a couple of the coaches over there, and they wanted me to pass along to everybody how happy they were with the conditions of those fields and the condition of the park overall. And when I told the coach I was talking to that when I was in Northern Soccer, we pulled money out of our own funds to buy grass seed for one of the fields up there, which is now a turf field. And if I had young kids, I'd go back to it. But I'm here now helping those kids. Later on that evening, I went to Mechanicsville Elementary School for their student business fair. And it was a cool idea. Had these students set up wares. They had to come up with a business plan or whatever. And you go in and you walk around and talk to the kids. I engaged with several of the kids. And had someone that was super excited that, oh, man, this guy's talking to me and wants to know about my stuff. And then you had someone a little shy. And it took a while to pull them out of their shell to talk about their wares. I had one boy who had done a little bit of art, and I asked him what was his inspiration, and he told me, and I said, well, you need to go look up Jackson Pollock. And then his mom looked up Jackson Pollock furiously on her phone and said, oh, look at this. And so it was sort of the same deal. So that got him a little excited, which was, you know, cool to see him get excited about that. The principal came up and thanked me for coming, because I did talk to him on the teacher appreciation dinner that I went to at the Elks Lodge. And I think he was like, okay, we'll see you there. But I showed up, and he was extremely happy. And so was Board of Education member, excuse me, Mary Washington, who was there. She was on her way out. I was on her way in. And that was, like I said, it was good to see that auditorium full. And like I said earlier, Mechanicsville Elementary School is a industrial zone right now with the construction that's going on. Saturday was Maryland Day, of course. I hope everybody got to celebrate. I know it's our county attorney, Mr. Hauser's favorite holiday. He'll tell you this. we started off at St. Clement's Island. Unfortunately, we had to have all of our festivities indoors due to the fabulous weather. There was a boat parade, and I do want to give a shout out to Terry Raley for organizing that. There were a total of 3 boats, I believe, which, given the weather and given how what short notice it was on that, was a pretty good turnout. If have a nice day, you could probably have a lot more boats, which would be awesome. Ended up down at St. Mary's City for their commemoration down there. Quite a few more people, and that was outdoors. It was a little cooler, and but that was a good event. Got to hear from Destination Southern Maryland talking about how Southern Maryland is a National Heritage Area, one of only 10, I believe, in the country. And if you get a chance, go to their website, Destination Southern Maryland, and read about that. And Sunday went to the Blessing the Fleet thank you party. Most of us were sponsors for Blessing the Fleet. Very sparsely attended, but I do appreciate the members of the Optimist Club putting that event on for the sponsors to say, you know, to say thank you, and, you know, to drum up business for next year. But it's still a good event. You get to talk to a lot of people in a nice, low pressure, mostly politics free environment, which, and it's a good family event also. And this Friday coming up is the Optimist Club's last fish and chips drive through dinner. Please come on out and support us if you can. You get to see yours truly there taking your orders. They don't allow me to handle money because of the position I'm in. They don't trust me, I guess. But here we are. So that's all I have, and thank you.